Morning guys, did you sleep well? That extra 10 minutes is good, no? 15 minutes. Like getting up at, what time do you get up? 5? 4? Where do you come from, man? Tumkur? 4 o'clock. Okay. So, generally when you hit the snooze button, you need to get up, but today, that snooze button would have gone off for 2-3 times maybe. But then you would have thought of my face and like, okay, time to go. This fellow we need to see. Okay, so today we'll start a very, very important chapter, both in terms of the syllabus, no doubt. That is come, this comes under module 2. So the new module. Anyway, that module we'll see later. Around 90 pages have made the material, of which, you know, last 30-40 pages or something else we'll see later. But yeah, 8 to 10 marks is what you can expect. And if you take economic law elective as well, this is there in that also. So the base is here, and then later, I mean the extra cases, etc., we could see there in economic law elective. But whether you take or not is immaterial, because I already told you, only if you are interested you should take. But whether you take or not, it's anyway there in corporate law and economic law. This, there is no elective here, right? You need to write the answers. 8 to 10 marks will come. The insolvency and bankruptcy code. So we need to understand the basics, the structure. Once the structure is understood, other things will be, will fall in place. So this is just blindly not, you know, reading everything. We need to understand the entire structure. Shall we start? All right. So first, so tell me guys, you and I, all of us are middle class people or very rich people? Middle class, lower middle class, we are happy with our lives. We just don't need all the luxuries, but basic necessities with some extra here and there if we have, we are happy. Tell me one thing, now what generally in the middle class and lower middle class families like we all come from, what is the one thing that, okay, two things that you would want to do in your life? Like one, like that, that's like the, if I tell you, you'll tell, you'll definitely agree. That is one thing that, your future plan, one thing. Build a house, see, all 3-4 people already told, yes, build a house. That is a general mentality, build a house. Travel, of course. Yeah, build a house and definitely travel. These two things, definitely, no doubt about it. Travel, I mean, according to our capacity, wherever we can, but travel. There is no point that just sitting in one place and slogging for, I mean, yesterday I was having a discussion after class with some of you as to what would you want to do after clearing. So would you want to die for next 10 years or would you want to have that off also a little bit? But it's a thing, if you join any company then you would have to slog. If you start something on your own also, you can't just traveling right away. You need to obviously set up base. Correct? For traveling we need something called money, right? For that we have to earn a little. We need to, of course, slog it out. That's the thing. So, yeah, these are the two things that we have. Of course, after completing our education, education also one thing for sure. Now, the thing is, travel, when it comes to travel, let us see. Many of us may not still have, I mean, what do you say, traveled on a plane. Now it probably is affordable, but think about it, maybe 10 years ago, 15 years ago. 15 years ago, travel was, I mean, in a flight was luxury. I remember when my dad used to get LTC, it was 11 days or 12 days he used to get. In that, if he had to go to Delhi, 4 days dying in train, 3 days. 3 days going, 3 days coming. So in the entire trip of 12 days, 6 days gone. But that actually was a part of the trip. It was not that we are traveling to a destination. The entire journey itself was so wonderful. But now, think about it, today morning I can teach here, evening I can go to Delhi, like next day I can go somewhere else. It has become affordable. But 15-20 years ago when you guys were kids, it was obviously difficult. And I'm sure all of us have traveled in bus or train, right? Only flight you'll travel? No. So, but the thing is, and some of us may not have traveled on a flight still. But now it is slightly affordable. Think about it, 15 years ago, that was a dream. So, Those of us who have traveled already on a flight, that first experience is something that you will cherish for the rest of your life. And every time you go on a flight, it is something that you feel like a kid and you will look out the window and all those things. But still that happens, that because we all come from middle class and lower middle class, families, and those are the little joys that we live on. So travel, especially via flight, was unheard of, and for middle class people, it was only actually about 30 years ago, if I had to go to Delhi or something, it would cost me, I mean, up and down, equivalent to today's INR, 40,000 rupees. Where will I spend 40,000 rupees to travel? And that to a normal ticket. Impossible, right? So the thing is, that was a dream. Of course, building a house or to travel. And other things, among other things, these are the two things that we generally have. Travel in a flight, travel, go to a foreign country maybe, right? That is some of the things. Like some people say, Sri Lanka is like there only, no, below. What? It's not a foreign country. It's right there, it's an extension. Correct? I want to go to Bangkok, I want to go to other places, Indonesia, other places, then they'll tell Australia, New Zealand. Sri Lanka, no, it's not a foreign country. It's like a beautiful version of Kerala anyway. So I'll not go there. But in fact, Sri Lanka is a wonderful country. So yeah, that's what it is. So travel is one thing that we always have on our mind. So you and I, unfortunately, did not have the money to travel. But one person changed everything. Who's that? Sri Vijay Mallya didn't do anything. It was one person called Captain Gopinath. Captain Vijay Mallya didn't do anything. He just looted us. I'll tell you how. If you say Vijay Mallya gave the, you know, dreams and all that, nothing. He shattered them. It was Captain Gopinath. Captain Gopinath said that, think about it, just let me create a flight, let me create a plan whereby people can travel at least in a flight. Forget about luxury, I don't want luxury. They just want to sit in a flight. I thought when I was, you know, going for the first time, I thought we had to sit on the plane. So I remember asking my mom, what it is? Is it a roller coaster, like on the plane, how will it be? Can I touch this? Obviously I was a kid, but what I'm saying is still. But all our lives, all the few years, we went by this train only. But once my dad surprised us by booking a flight. He pumped in all his savings. Government service, obviously, you may think that all are corrupt, but I'm proud to say my dad wasn't, because we've been transferred 27 times. So they have no attachment to any place, because every 6 months we used to be transferred. So the thing is, you know why people transfer. There's one more IAS officer, Mr. Kemka, 53 times. My dad was half of it, right? So the thing is, we've been transferred in his 37, 40 year career for 27 times. So I've actually studied in some 12, 15 schools. So I have no recollection of which school. If anybody asks me which school, I can give you a list. Correct? Different places. So the thing is, that's the problem. So all good officers, they'll be throwing like, carom board here and there. So we've been traveled. I lived in many villages as well. So it was a good, you know, life, of course. So the thing is, yeah, when he booked, he pumped in all his savings and he booked a flight for us. That was, you know, such a wonderful experience. So I thought, how will I sit on top? I was wearing shorts and all that day. I was like, how will I sit on top? Then I realized the first experience was something wonderful. So anyway, this Captain Gopinath said, now I need to really change the way the Indian travel industry, especially the airline industry, works. So he said, very simple. He said, first of all, if you just want to travel, budget, I want a smaller aircraft, let's say 100-120 seater. Why? Because if it's a small aircraft, you don't have to pay something called as landing charges. So you need to pay landing charges to the Airports Authority of India. Landing charges are quite a bomb, a lot. And that will be depending on your capacity of the plane. The plane capacity is around 200 or something, landing charges will increase. So for 100-120 seat, small seater, that less than 200, you don't have to pay landing charges. So first he said, let's make small aircrafts. Absolutely no landing charges for that. Good enough. So that I can reduce the price of the air ticket. Second, he said, it's catered to the middle class and lower middle class. They do not want luxury. They just want the experience of sitting in the flight at a very decent rate. So he said, all that nonsense, recliners remove. I need to make more space, I need to make good chairs, but of course, I will not make some luxurious chairs, small version of chairs, smaller thing, it's okay. One and a half hours, they'll adjust, no recliner, they removed the recliner concept. So it was reclined at some 20-25 degree, they reclined it for sure, but then they said, stop it there. So they blocked, they obviously locked it. So recliner concept only was removed, fair enough. And then they said, for a one and a half hour flight, why do you need food? Correct? And we are lower middle class people, if you open our bags, three tiffin boxes will be there. For that, for night, everything will be there. So they said, no need of any food and other nonsense. So he said, if I want food, just keep some 3-4 sandwiches and charge exorbitant amount, 700 rupees, 800 rupees, no one should buy. That was the idea, that was the instruction. Nobody should buy anything, so don't buy the sandwiches there. So the thing is, they charged 800 rupees, 900 rupees per sandwich. Will anybody buy? No. So that's the deal, very simple. Then water, drink and go, no, for 1 hour, what water you want? Correct, drink and go water, no problem. Nothing will happen. So yes, so drinking, just water also they charge exorbitant amount, 200, 300, 400 rupees. So they made the world's first budget airline. And actually the fueled the dreams of people who wanted to travel by air. I remember my grandmom's sister had never traveled. She was almost like 55, 60, she had never traveled that time. So she was first time ever in her life she traveled. You know, she went to Hyderabad and came back, that's all. Went to Hyderabad, said hi in the airport, came back. So because just want, it's, imagine a 60 year old lady like that, so many people only because of Air Deccan. And she traveled in Air Deccan, I remember that very, you know, distinctly. Because the thing is, that's what it is. So you need to obviously go. It was affordable to the lower middle class and the middle class people like us. So there, if you see the, what do you say, the, I have some pictures to show you. This is Air Deccan, guys. See how it is? Very, very crammed up. I'll show you one more pic. This is proper Air Deccan. Right? It was a smaller plane. Correct? The only difference is if you put one rod here, it's like a bus only. Correct? That's all. So they said no luxury. Absolutely no luxury. I don't want luxury. Let them sit. That's it. And the only thing is they can't stand there and all. Correct? They can't stand there in the plane. The rod and all don't keep. Otherwise they'll stand 100%. So if you see, and first when you go inside, kerchief. Throw on one seat. Correct? All that not allowed. So seat number was there, thankfully. That is one thing. Otherwise imagine our fellows, just go there, one kerchief, one bag, they'll throw. So all that is not there. So if you see, yeah, this is very, very, what do you say, no recliner and no nonsense. This was a slightly bigger plane. Anyway, this was Air Deccan, how it was. So that was Captain Gopinath's dream. But of course, there are other operational problems that we face in the airline industry. And of course, cutthroat competition. And other players will not allow you to grow. And you need to be a businessman, not a visionary. Visionary is somebody who will obviously have that vision to help people, all that, okay. But you also need to be a cutthroat businessman. But Captain Gopinath was not a businessman. He was an army man, but he was not a businessman. So unfortunately, it failed. It did not take off because obviously, I mean, there are many operational other difficulties as well. So Air Deccan was completely wiped out and he was extremely sad. And this is the actual current Air Deccan version. They are operating small chartered flights. The other thing that I showed you, that also is like a budget flight only, this one. This is the Air Deccan version 2 as of now. It's still there. No luxury, no nonsense, nothing. So they said, and also they said, when it comes to air hostesses, why do you need some 5-6 people? For 120-200 people, one enough. Maximum two. Correct? So earlier, I mean, in those air hostesses, there are some 5-6. So stewards and air hostesses not needed. Purser. The other guy is called not air host. He's a purser. The guy. So the purser and the air hostess not needed. So they just said two. One enough. So maximum two. That's it. So they actually cut down the costs a lot. They genuinely tried to cut down the cost, but still it could not run. So it got closed down. And because of that, even the dreams of the middle class people gone. But these guys revolutionized the industry because they gave at such dirt cheap rates that the other flights were operating at huge, or at least, you know, the, a good markup, they also started reducing their prices. It's like Jio. Jio came, Airtel, 200 MB, 250 rupees, and now 1 TB. We are all TB holders, correct? If not anything, we at least have terabytes of data available. So the thing is, that's what happened. So he actually revolutionized the industry a little. Now, they were in dire straits. They were in dire straits. Now enters our hero. Yes, who? Shri? Respect you have to give. Shri Vijay Mallya. So if you see, again, coming to us, when you have to build a house, we need to take a loan. Have you ever applied for a loan in your life, or have you seen your parents apply? Yes. I remember my dad took a loan to build a house and for a site which he could not afford. But obviously the government that time, for all IAS and IPS officers on HSR layout, they gave a, some allotted rate they gave for all IAS and IPS and IFS officers. So it was an IAS, IFS, IPS officer colony in HSR layout. So they gave a plot. Of course, that I still remember, the entire thing was plot plus house construction was around 19 lakhs. I still remember that. So he had taken a loan. I remember, despite being a government servant, loan should come easily. But I remember him running from pillar to post. We were posted somewhere in Shimoga, I think. And from there, he had to travel all the way to Bangalore and all the way to Mysore to get some loan. And every weekend, he used to travel to beg for a loan. To get the loan only, he traveled at least around for 2 months. Right? Just being a government servant at a decently high position in the Karnataka government and in Indian Forest Service. So, but still, imagine, think about that. Despite being government servant, you had to run around. And I remember there was a celebration in our house after we cleared the loan. He obviously took some 15 years to clear it, but as per the proper plan. But after we cleared, we had a small celebration at the house. So we all have our own small celebrations. You buy a small car, or you buy a vehicle, there will be a celebration. So we bought a third-hand Fiat car, I remember. A third-hand, not even second-hand. Correct? Somebody had bought it, some old, that Premier Padmini, you have seen that Fiat car we had. So that car also, when we bought, it was such a mini celebration at home. So we are all coming from that family. So you can connect to what I'm trying to tell. Unless there are Ambani sitting here. Good, but you will connect in a different way. Like when you buy a Audi, you will celebrate. And that's how it is. So if you see, anyway. So the thing is, we obviously had to build a house and loan. Why I'm telling you is this is, when you and I want to get a loan, is it easy? No. They will ask you some 100, 200, 300 documentation and they'll, you know, suck the life out of us. However, there is something called crony capitalism. Have you heard of this term? Us is a capitalistic society, socialistic society, or what is it? Communism, what is there in India? Democracy, okay. But then in terms of the business, what is it? Capitalistic, yes. Capitalistic, as simple as that, the person who has money will run the show. I have already experienced it and saw that also in managing director's provisions, the way the laws have been changed to accommodate these people. So what is this crony? Crony means what? Crony means friend. So you and I getting a loan, not possible. Friend. Crony means a friend in a negative way though. So crony capitalism. So if I go to a bank and ask for a loan, they'll ask me some 1,000 questions. Correct? But if somebody goes, like Vijay Mallya or some businessman goes, the loan, he need not go. First of all, the bankers only will come. There's a different ball game altogether. Now, I have seen that if you're a salaried employee or if you are a middle class, lower middle class person, to get something, it is very, very difficult. We need to run from pillar to post. That is how it is. So, however, for these businessmen, it's very, very easy. They just go there and get things done. There's a nexus between politicians, the bureaucracy, and these businessmen. And of course, the banks. When I talk about the banks, I'm not talking about the private banks. I'm talking about the public sector undertakings. Crony capitalism, because of which they just take loan left, right, center, and they will not pay. The thing is, who will issue the loan, by the way? It's the management. You've already seen in the Chanda Kuchar case, management. They saw that, okay, husband also needed a loan, so give it to one company, and that company will give loan to one more company. Gone. Second, you already seen in Nirav Modi's case, when Nirav Modi PNB Bank gave guarantee. Would you get a guarantee like that if you went? No. He got a guarantee and he ran away. Right? So it is so easy. That's called crony capitalism. What will happen because of that? The non-performing assets. The non-performing assets will definitely increase because they will just take loan without any credibility and it will increase. So I'll just play a short video. This is a discussion on NDTV. You will be shocked to know the NPA rate in public sector banks. Public sector banks, it's crazy. We need to see from a different point of view, not merely reading the theory. That anyway will come.
Public sector banks, look at it from 2015, 14, 15 upwards. The non-performing assets, bad bank, bad debts are rising, particularly in public sector banks. It's almost 12% now. Private sector banks, not such a big volume in terms of absolute numbers, but also they have not got, they're much more careful. Is this an indication of what they call crony capitalism and the whole system is giving loans to big industrialists? But public sector banks are in a bit of trouble.
You raise a good question, but I think we should be a little bit careful here. Huh?
Yeah.
I think the standard view of public sector banks is, you know, there's a lot of crony capitalism, whatever, yeah. Right? But let's just, I think, step back and say one thing, right? When India was having its boom period, right, when a lot of the infrastructure got built, I mean, the private sector banks never participated. So in some senses, you're only looking at one side of the problem. I think the public sector banks financed it and so. Second, I think one has to be really careful about viewing this as a morality play, that it's all about crony capitalism.
So, he just said morality play, and that is the truth, because obviously you and I will never get any loan, or even if we get, it is at extremely high rate or whatever, unfairness, whatever it is. Anyway, so now the businessman like Vijay Mallya. So Vijay Mallya, his father was Vitthal Mallya. Vitthal Mallya was a very, very famous businessman, correct? So he had made a lot of money. All this Kisan jams, all that he had a Kisan company also, had invested a lot in that. So suddenly, unfortunately, he died. And the entire business, the entire, what do you say, all his businesses were inherited by his young son, Shri Vijay Mallya, at age 27. He was just 27 when he inherited his father's entire business. He was the heir to the entire throne, so to speak. So at 27, the thing is, obviously, as I told you that day, 18 to 21 recklessness. At 27, he was little reckless, but very, very aggressive. So first thing he did was he sold off that Kisan. Sold it off. He sold off everything. And he obviously, his father had invested in this United Breweries, right, UB. This guy, that was around, if I'm not wrong, that time it was around 350 crore turnover. And this guy slowly built it to almost 6,000 crore value. He invested in lot of things, many, many things. I'm not saying he's a bad businessman. He was very, very good businessman. But the thing is, he had, obviously, it was balance brought down. Now, if I give you 1 crore rupees, if you're smart enough, will you do it? Will you do business? Yes. All of us can. Most of us can. Why do we die? We die because we don't have money. First thing is money. You invest, correct, then you will do anything that you can. You first have to invest. The thing is that risk appetite must be there. You need money. So that's why I respect Dhirubhai Ambani more than Mukesh Ambani, because Mukesh Ambani had a base already. Yes, of course he was smart, no doubt about it. He's diversified like crazy. But it was that guy who sold petrol in a petrol bunk, Dhirubhai Ambani, who actually turned that, and it's a classic rags to riches story. So I respect people who have come up from nothing and become millionaires rather than the guys who are the heirs to the throne. Of course, there no doubt, nothing to take away from them, with all due respect. They have diversified and made business something else. But that's how it is. But nevertheless, this guy at age 27, he was the heir to a, what crazy amount of money. But even he was smart, yet he was reckless. So he sold off all profitable ventures, but still, he had invested in so many things, real estate and whatnot, FMCG. But one thing he realized, that in India only one thing runs. What is that? Liquor. Correct? It runs. But one peculiar thing in India, that time even now, you cannot advertise liquor. We are in 2020 and that Ford versus Ferrari movie, we are still, blurring the images of liquor. I cannot believe it. So we are, India, though at the end of the person who is banning that only, having a drink at home that night. That's another issue. Hypocrites of the highest order. But the thing is, that's what happened. So liquor you cannot obviously do. You cannot advertise. Have you seen anything like, Kingfisher beer, come and drink? No. What do they do then? What type of marketing branding do they do? Of course, that's called secretive or surreptitious marketing, where without obviously, concealed marketing. You need to bring your brand out without knowing that what you do. You've seen a Royal Challenge bottled drinking water, Carlsberg soda, right? Then that Red Piper or whatever, back Piper, that is your CDs, music CDs it seems. Correct? So that is your marketing that you have to do. So this guy, Vijay Mallya, what he did? Branding. That's what he started. Complete branding of the stuff. Brilliant he was. Really brilliant. First he started this Kingfisher Villa. He named his property. This is his house in Goa. On the main road, Kalangut Baga main road, he had his house, Kingfisher Villa. He changed his name, the name of the property only to Kingfisher Villa. Easy, best to do. That's the best thing to do. That's first. Then, Formula One. He invested in Formula One. Yes, definitely. And you can see the lifestyle itself, guys. The lifestyle. I tried searching for many photos, but this was the most decent photo that I could get. Yes. So I just said Vijay Mallya with the ladies, and so many things came. Anyway, so this is the one thing that I obviously thought, okay, is at least a little decent. So the lifestyle itself, he was a flamboyant, he was the middle class man's dream. Right? Even you just close your eyes, like, I want this life. It's not about what this picture, what I'm trying to tell is that flamboyance, that exuberance, that luxury. That is a middle class man's dream. Middle class man started looking up to this person. You have seen UB City. Isn't it like some foreign country? Actually it is. Right? Whether you've been abroad or not, you would have seen some pictures. And actually when you enter UB City and if you go there on top to have some food or something, it is definitely not like Bangalore. I'm not talking about now. Now they've made Brigade Road and all those things, very nice, Church Street. I'm talking about 7-8 years ago, think about it. There was no such place like UB City. So he had that, when you entered UB City, you had that newfound respect. And I remember we were auditors for a couple of UB groups, companies, listed companies. So when I entered, there was like almost like a 50-foot, statue, not a statue sort of a thing, but some, a TV in which this fellow is all Kingfisher, only about Kingfisher. The branding was insane. That is one thing that he did. Of course, all the events that he created, he named it Kingfisher. The Kingfisher Ball, the Kingfisher that, Kingfisher that. So basically, people thought that, okay, this Kingfisher is something to look forward to. And to actually, this is the middle class man's dream. Then, of course, RCB. Invested in our RCB. Yes, we have been winning very nicely from all that. That is the only thing we have to do. Despite having the best player, a couple of best players, that's what it is. And the who's who of the industry, where all he was, flanked by the who's who of the industry. And that's how it is. A very, very luxurious lifestyle. Extremely luxurious lifestyle. That was the personal branding he did. Now, with this, think about it. If Vijay Mallya comes to a normal banker's house and says, sir, I want a loan. The banker is already impressed by this lifestyle. You need to understand why IBC came. I'm not telling some random story here. It's actually why IBC came. So, this... when some banker comes and tells that, boss, when this Vijay Mallya goes to a bank and says, I want a loan. Bankers at the end of the day, middle class people, so they like, Vijay Mallya is asking me for a loan. And if you see Nirav Modi's case also, all the bankers had 1 crore property, 2 crores property. How? Their salary is some 80,000 rupees per month. But they have 2 to 3 properties each amounting to 2-3 crores. How is that possible? Crony capitalism. So Vijay Mallya goes to them and says, please give me a loan. And you take a small cut in that. Of course, I will give you a couple of things. Have you already traveled in a yacht sometime? I can, you know, take you on a yacht ride. Actually, he did it. And not to normal people, to the DGMs, to the GMs of the banks. Right? You can come to Kingfisher Villa and stay. Think of it as your own house. Right? So if you are a lower middle class banker and you are getting access to this, and in exchange you need to give a loan, your money, definitely not other people's money, your and my hard-earned money, I can give Aram Singh. Private company, private banks will not give. Public sector undertakings, who cares? They gave because they said Vijay Mallya can never falter. Let's give it to Vijay Mallya. So with this, his flamboyance is something unheard of and unthinkable. So we were also the auditors of Bangalore Turf Club. So once I had gone there, I remember I was seeing him. Everything was fine. They were all page 3-eyes there and all that. We were like on Chapadasi's wearing informals. Auditors, no. We were just seeing there. But these fellows, all page 3. Those guys are, you should see their suits and see their flamboyance. You know, your socialites. Right, they're called page 3-eyes because on the page 3rd of all your newspaper, their pictures will be, the entire thing will be adorned by their pictures. The socialites, and once Vijay Mallya entered, the entire thing changed. I'm not kidding. He came in some swanky car and he got down 5 ladies around him. That's how he came. I'm not kidding. That is true flamboyance. And the thing is, in some colorful attire, and there was a mini breweries there inside Bangalore Turf Club. So people, you could make fresh beer and have, see the race. That was, and in Bangalore, in a place like Bangalore, right? So we just saw all that, and in front there was on Darshini, we were drinking coffee and discussing that. That's the thing. That is us, right? Other people. So it was Vijay Mallya and other people. So it's a two different worlds right opposite each other. Right opposite that, our institute is also there now. Now at that time it was not there. One small shop opposite the institute, one that fellow was there since ever on Gadi, tea he'll give. So you saw all those things, came out and had tea. And we were discussing the flamboyance. So when all of us were impressed by Vijay Mallya, think about the bankers when I said I'll give you easy access. So they gave. How much they gave loan? This much they gave. SBI, 1600 rupees, no, crore. PN, all PSU, you see the only two private banks that you can probably see would be Axis and ICICI also was there. Where is ICICI? Okay, this may not be. Okay, this is other three banks. These three banks, no? Other three banks. So these other three banks are ICICI and HDFC. Barring that, all PSU, 1600, PNB 800, IDBI 800, Bank of India, Baroda, all these things. Crazy, 6,963, and with interest all, if you add some 7,500 crores, they gave. And for what? Kingfisher. He said, I'm going to make the world's first luxury airline, which is affordable. Lower middle class and middle class people can go. And that was his idea. What did he do first? He bought Air Deccan. So, and he told the world, you've already impressed by his flamboyance. He told the world, do not worry. I told all Indians, do not worry. I'm going to create something which you are going to love. And you are going to respect me and you're going to worship me. So he said, Kingfisher Airlines he created. And what did he do in Kingfisher Airlines? First thing he did was, he removed all those seats. Correct? He removed all these. See how this seat is, guys. You won't even feel like sitting on it. It is Air Deccan. Right? Correct. So the thing is, he removed all the seats and he said, now the real, color is red and I need like proper leather, not some Rexin material. So leather seats, luxury. It was all about luxury, right? This is, by the way, Kingfisher Airlines, the business class. But of course, this is Kingfisher Airlines. And he said, there should be a bar inside. This is the airline, by the way. People should travel in luxury. It should not be very expensive. It should be affordable. So he made two things. One is for the luxury aircraft Kingfisher and one more Kingfisher Red or something he made. That is for you and me. Correct? So we could travel also. But what did he do? He said, let's make it recliner seats. Indians should travel in luxury for the same cost. And let's increase the fleet. They bought all the Airbuses and all those things. Because 9,000 crore, if I have, I can do whatever I want, no? That's the thing. Everything crony capital. Just by that one person, impressed the hell out of everyone. And after that, what did he do? Yes, he said he was the only CEO in the entire world who handpicked his air hostesses. There were personal interviews with Vijay Mallya. I'm not kidding. He handpicked the air hostesses. And he actually was very sexist in the sense that he said it should only be 18 to 22. That's it. If the lady is 22 plus, rejected. It was shameful. And all the middle class people fell for it. 18 to 22. Correct? So because have you gone to Air India and all that? Yeah. Correct. So the thing is, middle class people used to go to Air India and other airlines and all those things. Correct. There was a lady standing there. So this guy went and said, ma'am, do you need any help? She turned around and said, I am the air hostess. You tell me. You need any help. Correct. So that was the case in other airlines. If you know what I mean. Now you realized. Good morning. So in this thing, he changed the entire dynamics. And that was the eligibility criteria. 18 to 22. Think about it. More than 22, reject. Crazy. He was the only guy to do that. You know, first, you know, CEO in the... Even Richard Branson didn't do. He's also a little flamboyant. Correct? But, you know, he did not do that. Anyway, so what happened was, this is what happened. And he said, we are Indians, we need luxury. First time ever in a domestic airline, he created the entertainment system. Unheard of. From Bangalore to Goa, you're going 40 minutes flight, you can actually watch something. Some serial, Kannada serial you can watch. Correct? He was the first guy who created, think about it, crazy. So, what is the cost per seat, guys, if you do all these things? Did he increase the rate? No, only marginal increase. Marginal increase. And this, you know, crazy. Entertainment system, each thing for a local flight had an entertainment system. And of course, the thing is, initially when, I don't know if you remember, when you used to go to a flight, they used to give chocolates. Correct? In entire tray, they used to give chocolates. And we are Indians, we are shameless. When they hold out a tray, what should you take? One or two. Okay, two, at least one you take. One or two. But we are Indians, one handful and one more handful. Correct? Shameless fellows that we are. We used to take that. It's free, no. The moment they say free, first tell us how much you have to pay. No, it's on the house. First of all, you have to understand what is on the house. Then, okay. Take. So, one and two handfuls, not one and two. This guy started giving these luxury chocolates. When I say luxury, I'm talking about 5-star Dairy Milk, 10 rupees, voila, and in a tray again. Just because the chocolate size gets bigger, will our, you know, shamelessness reduce? No. Same, with that same 5 rupees, 10 rupees, one or two handful. Correct? And if you see, I'll just put up there this picture, you see this was a Kingfisher airline. And as you can see, this lady is holding what? A pouch. This pouch had a, you know, wet towel. Correct? Have you ever seen a local, normal airline, somebody giving you a wet towel? No. So wet, you know, fragrant towel where you could just, you know, wipe your face. But we are Indians. Correct? We'll probably have a bath with that towel. We'll ask for soap also, if, you know, soap, shampoo. And after you give it back, that white color would have become some black or some different color only. You cannot use it. This is a cost. Each one is a cost. Think about it. And in this pouch, believe it or not, they gave a booklet, they gave a pen, and they gave headphones. All free with Kingfisher branding. The moment he announced for the same rate at Deccan Air, 500 rupees more maybe, you're getting all these things. This was, I think, Kingfisher Red or something. And you're getting all these things. Wouldn't people jump? Yes. So the thing is, when you hear the word free, that's it. All of us fell for it. Even I have two Kingfisher headsets at home. Correct? I have just kept it to see how we got played. All of us. So the thing is, that's it. Kingfisher headsets. You had a pen, you had a, you know, booklet. All this for some 2,000, 3,000 rupees. We all fell for it. And he was termed as the new, what do you say, revolutionary in the entire airline industry. He was really called as a revolutionary in the airline industry. Now the thing is, the cost, this is, by the way, looks like a house, but this is actually a flight. This is a luxury thing, this is the business class. But still, he changed the way things are. Air India, what do you say, business class is, you know, 1.5 times the seat and 1.5 times leg space, that's it, nothing else. And one pillow they'll give, which the previous guy had used, that's all. But if you see, he really revolutionized the way the luxury travel looked. And people could afford this at a slightly extra price. Now, the thing is, cost was some 6,000, 7,000 per seat and he's charging 3,000. Can he ever make a profit? No. Was this written in the, what do you say, entire business model? Yes. But still, did he get loan? Yes. Because of crony capitalism. As simple as that. He got a loan. He got a loan, superb loan. He got from everywhere. You saw, no? 1,200, 2,000, 3,000 crore loan he got. Totally 7,000, 8,000 crore. 6,000, 7,000 crore loan he got. So the thing is, Bajaj of Bajaj Industries was just commenting someday that Kingfisher did not have any business model. It only had models. That's true. Zero business model. With zero business model, he managed to get loan sanctioned. And when your cost only is per seat 7,000, you are charging 3,500, 4,000, it is impossible that you can make profit. So that's why slowly and steadily started making a loss. And something which was, it was valued, the loan, actually it was valued at around, the share price was at 48 rupees, and they valued the share price at 65 rupees. And they started restructuring the loan also. Not only did they, you know, give a loan, but also restructured the loan for him. 40 rupees one, and a company is not doing well, you valued it at 65, as if it is 65, and restructured the loan also. And your and my money, by the way. And for that, in return, you would have got some house or some other thing. That's all the banker. He is happy, and you know, his money is not involved. That's the thing. So that's what happened, and slowly and steadily it fell. And Kingfisher share, 22nd June 2000, see the share price, how much? 1 rupee. Correct. This was because of the auditor, who in this audit report he said going concern assumption is invalid. That's it. In how many days? In 3 days it fell to 1 rupee. That's the power of your signature. The auditor said going concern assumption is invalid. The management is telling it's going concern. I am telling it's just gonna go. That in concern is not there. So the thing is, that's what happened. 1 rupee. It fell to 1 rupee. This is the actual, you know, screenshot. Correct? Where everything zero. Zero, zero, everything. Minus. So if you see there, volatility, everything. They are only shocked. What is beta? What is daily volatility? Nothing. What 1 rupee, what volatility will show? So the thing is that everything went. So that's how it fell. But at the end of the day, when they lifted the corporate veil to catch Vijay Mallya, as I told you, he was a well-connected man. And apparently there are allegations that the politicians and also the enforcement directorate, which had a lookout notice for him, they only allowed him free passage outside the country. How is it possible when your passport is frozen, when you are on the blacklist, and when you are so flamboyant like Vijay Mallya, how is it possible that you can run away? Obviously, with a nexus of all the politicians. It's impossible otherwise. At the end of the day, whose money went? Your and my money. Hard-earned money. So we slog it out. We work 16 hours a day. We put whatever little savings in the bank, wiped out. I am not saying we will not get the money back. But what I am saying is, see the impact on the economy. And there is just one person. There is just one person. He promised to pay the, what do you say, air hostesses and the pilots. Promised to pay the air hostesses and pilots. Any idea how long they have not been paid? See, it's all about one man. If the main managing director comes and tells, do not worry, I will pay, people will just generally, no, believe it. Do not worry, I will pay, people will generally believe. It's, India is all based on blind trust. I asked you on the first day only, I asked you today also, what is the guarantee that I am a CA? There is no guarantee. But you're sitting here because there is trust. So the thing is, it's all based on trust. When Vijay Mallya came and told, we are going through a problematic time, do not worry, I am here for you, I will give you salary, people fell for it. And the air hostess and the pilots worked for free for almost 9 to 10 months without taking 1 rupee because of that bond that they had with the guy. It was not about Kingfisher, it was about Vijay Mallya. It is always about the men behind the show. Right? It's always about the people behind the show. When the managing director is coming and telling you, do not worry, I am here for you, you would definitely listen. That's what happened. Now, without paying anybody, he just ran away. And last year, he went to the court. Since he is taking asylum in UK, if he wants to spend his own money, he has to take the permission of the court. He went last year to a UK court and said, I am unable to spend money, I need permission. He was spending 4 lakhs rupees per week. I'm not kidding. 4 lakh rupees per week he was spending. That was not enough for him. That was not enough. So he requested the bank that he wants to spend more, and they granted to spend his own money, by the way, because he's taking asylum in the foreign country. They approved last year for him to spend 16 lakh rupees per week, 4 times. I'm talking about per week, 16 lakhs per week. Correct? So, as I told you, what is the average income of an Indian? 1 lakh per annum. 1 lakh per annum versus 16 lakhs per week. And the, what do you say, what is the amount pending? 9,000 crores. So, he just ran away. So, the thing is, everything, do you think he's obviously poor now? No. He was called as the king of good times. And after he left, they started selling everything, that branding, everything attached. Kingfisher Villa didn't get sold for a long time. Recently it got sold, but didn't get sold for a long time. When they opened up the bidding for the Kingfisher logo, not even one bidder came. Forget about base amount, one bidder also didn't come. They said, I don't want anything to do with that company. And ultimately, you and I suffered. So when you and I go for a loan, so much they do. But when this guy with zero business model goes and gets, he got 9,000 crore. That's the story of our lives. This is the basic. Now the thing is, what does the poor this guy do? Our pilot. Pilot was not paid for 11, 12 months. In India, where do you go? Court. Which court? Which court would you go? Normal. Some civil court, you will go saying that non-payment of salaries. How many in 3 days it will be settled? Indian court, 3 years it will be settled? No. He will retire as a pilot, his son will become a pilot, daughter will become pilot, still he will not get any money. So he has to run from pillar to post for 10 lakh rupees. And Vijay Mallya knows for 10 lakhs and all, they won't care. They'll join one more airline and they'll forget about all this very soon. They'll drink UB, and my companies only they'll drink. And they'll forget about all these things. So if you see, if a normal pilot has to go, that's it. There is no way in hell you can go anywhere. And if banks have to sue, where will they sue? They'll go to the normal, they can go to NCLT, National Company Law Tribunal. They will go to criminal court against, to file charges against him. They'll go to criminal court, civil court. Correct? There is one more law protecting recovery of debt due to banks and financial institution act, RDDBFI act. I will go to the adjudicating authority under RDDBFI. So what I am trying to tell is, each banker will do whatever he feels like. But what about this pilot? He can only go to the civil court. It will go on for ages and ages together. There was probably one property of Kingfisher which the civil court, said that I'm going to attach that property. From RDDBFI, the, debt recovery tribunal will jump and say, stay order. Correct? Can the same case go in various courts? Yes. Then there is one more, SICA, Sikh Industries Companies Act. In that, there is one thing called BIFR, Board for, Industrial and Financial Reconstruction. They give a stay order, stop, this property is mine. Then somebody else gets a stay order from a high court saying that stop. For one property, they are all dying some years together, and then what to do? Nothing will happen. Who has a charge on Kingfisher Villa? Why was it not sold? Because it was under stay order for so long. Everyone staked the claim because it at least some proper value. Logo also, everybody staked the claim. And they got from various courts. Which court is superior? Supreme Court is fine, that's fine. But among these courts, whose stay order, who can put a stay order against whom? There are all different laws. One I have NCLT, then the old 1956 I had CLB. One is NCLT, one is Civil Court, one is Criminal Court. All at the same level, but different acts. And I have, the DRT, Debt Recovery Tribunal. Then I have BIFR, Board for Industrial and Financial Reconstruction. Where will I go? And think about the poor pilot. He can only go to the normal court. So this was the scene which was there, where we had no clue what to do. Where to go, don't know. What to do, don't know. So we need to understand the history. I know it is, it will take all this time I took. See these cases in page number 1.1. These are all the earlier insolvency regimes that we had. Companies Act, SICA, Sikh Industrial Companies Act, Recovery of Debts Due to Banks. Then we had SURFACE also, Securitization and Reconstruction of Financial Asset and Enforcement of Security Interest Act, which is there in the syllabus, by the way. Right? Then you had Companies Act 2013. Of course, we had that. Where would you go? Forget about that last part. That is what we are discussing now. Where would you go, guys? Which act will override which act? Partnership firm means you'll go to Indian Partnership Act. Which act will override which act was always a problem. What to do now? And one more thing. Let us say under SURFACE. Under SURFACE. Everything was so procedure oriented. SURFACE installment date unpaid. 9000 crore Vijay Mallya has not paid. 90 days I have to wait. After 90 days waiting, the advance would be classified as NPA. Right? And then bank will send a notice demanding to the borrower. Where is Vijay Mallya? Not in the country only. Right? And 60 days, after 60 days, imagine first 90 days, then 60 days, then this. After you classify as NPA, bank should send a notice. They are scared because their bank auditors will be dying, no? NPA, NPA, NPA. So they are scared to send notices. So this, how many days? God only knows. So basically, just to send a notice, you will take minimum 6 months. Correct? If borrower fails to pay within 60 days, only then the enforcement of security interest would begin under SURFACE. Whatever security you had, you can claim money on that only after so many days. That is after 6 months. And mind you, for this, how many people should agree? 60% of value. 60% of value, which means in this list that I showed you, in this list that I showed you, out of 7,000 crore, what is 60%? Around 4,200 crore. So Axis Bank, to whom they owe 50 crore, can they apply for ESI? No. These three put together, Federal Bank, Punjab and Sindh Bank and Axis Bank, no. They needed the blessing of which guy? This big shot, SBI. And if SBI manager is in my pocket, he will still not go ahead with ESI. It is enforcement of security interest. Think about it. So, even to recover, how much percentage? 60% of them had to agree. 60% in value, outstanding loan. So if to recover, to ask you only, I need some 6-7 months. Where will I recover? They lifted the corporate veil. That 6 months was enough for him to escape. So he told all the employees, I will definitely pay 100%. Mark my words. Next day, not there. Overnight escape. Nirav Modi, overnight escape. So, which act will override which act, guys? Any idea? There is nothing like that. So, they had to introduce something which would obviously settle all these issues. That is why, now, intro. What did they introduce? Insolvency and Bankruptcy Act. Code. What's the difference? Spelling and all was different. So we had everywhere act, 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 act. They wanted to change the spelling. So, code. Looks different. Sorry? Collection of various laws it is. Collection of various laws. compilation of, okay, like our compilation, suggested answers. Okay, what is code and act?
It repeats so many parts.
Does it repeal? Okay. What does it do? What is the difference between code and act? Why isn't it Insolvency and Bankruptcy Act? Question number one. Second question, what is the difference between insolvency and bankruptcy? Insolvency and bankruptcy. Can you use it interchangeably? Articleship entire period, I am insolvent or am I bankrupt? I am broke, we say, no, always. At the end of the month, I am broke. For articleship, during the month also broke, what, end of the month? Correct? So, throughout the month, we are throughout the year, we are broke. So, what is broke? Is it insolvent or bankrupt? Insolvent. That's the thing. So, first question you answer, what is the difference between code and act? Collection of laws. Okay, then compilation. Then which act will override which act? It was always a problem. I could sue in each law and there was no law overriding any law. So rather than bringing one more act and one more authority in that who will again do the same thing, they decided to bring a code. This is one of the most landmark laws to be passed by our country. What does a code do? In a code, something called codification happens. So I told you there are so many here, Companies Act. In Companies Act, CLB was there, CICA, BIFR was there, here DRT was there, Companies Act, NCLT was there. All these things will now be codified into one, and that is IBC. Means the adjudicating authority of IBC will override all these provisions. In an act, on the other hand, if you see, cases can still go under other areas. Correct? But here, a process of codification, the recovery proceedings, and everywhere it was negative, Sick Industry Companies Act. See the heading of the section itself, it says the entire act, Sick Industry Companies Act. Recovery of debts due to banks. Securitization and reconstruction. There was no positive thought of revival. Though insolvency and bankruptcy is a state where we don't have money, this act, this code aimed at revival of the companies in a different way. So, and eventually what happened, as I told you, if some company is going, Kingfisher logo, when Kingfisher on its prime, when you wanted the logo, would you buy it? Yes. But when Kingfisher anyway is a lost cause, would you buy it? No. When the company is going for winding up, will you buy that property at the market value or distress sale? Whatever rate you get, you will buy. Distress sale. So all that had to change, and this code came by a process of codification, things changed. So what is the difference between act and a code? What is the difference between act and code? Let's just see that. What is the difference between act and code? What does the code do? What does the act do? Quickly we'll see difference between act and code. So in the field of law, enactment, statute, bill, regulation which has passed through various legislative steps. Does it mean this code is not passed through legislative steps? Yes, but it tries to cover a complete system of laws. So as you rightly said, collection, compilation, whatever is called a code. That process of taking the various parts of different laws and making one law, that is called, and adding much more to it, that is called codification. Thus, act is decision made, passed into law, whereas code is what? Collection of acts already passed into law. There is no rule when to use act and when to use code, no problem. It's just like our Criminal Justice Act versus Penal Code. So, act is a decision passed into law, where a code is a collection of already existing laws. However, apart from collection, it's not just collection, it's just that from that place you can check other things. Means all these things that have come here from various sources now will fall under IBC. Which means, under IBC, if a case is pending, what happens to all the other cases? They have to stop immediately. If you come under IBC, he is the big daddy now. Because if you come under IBC, other things have to stop. As simple as that. Correct? Now under IBC, now the in the earlier regimes, what can a pilot do? Nothing. Under IBC, a pilot can go. Pilot can go and apply saying that, sir, they have not paid me my amount. Who will they go to? National Company Law Tribunal. A pilot, how much he has not paid? Let's just see there. One more thing. You have not been paid, SBI was not paid 3,800 crores. Pilot is not paid 40 lakhs. Who can go? Pilot also can go. Now the question is, what is the minimum amount? I didn't get a headset, can I go? I paid for it. What do you think? What is the minimum amount? In the other laws, there was, you know, obviously, for if you see, remember in Surfaisi, for you to apply, what is the value? 60%. So in 7,000 crore, 4,200 crore. If you owe 4,200 crore, only they can go. Axis Bank 50 crore, those banks 60, 70, all put together also is some 300 crore, they can't go. 4,200 crore, only those fellows can go. Under IBC? Under IBC? 1 lakh rupees, think about it. That's it. If the company owes you 1 lakh, if has not paid 1 lakh, you can go under IBC. So the pilot has not been paid 20 lakhs, 30 lakhs, 10 lakhs, he can go and say, tell the NCLT, sir, I have been asking them, I have been sending various notices, I have a mail trial and they have not bothered paying. I have proof, I am just not simply telling, I am not doing it. SBI was a normal creditor, financial creditor and all that. Who is a pilot, employee? Can employees go in the normal, can employee go to NCLT and all that? No. The only option earlier was what? Civil court. Here, employee can go to NCLT. When the pilot is entering NCLT, can SBI come and tell, shut up and come, 1,800 crore, I am only not tensed. Vijay Mallya, I will definitely pay. He has promised. What do you think? Nothing doing. I can go. This is actually the aftermath of Kingfisher only, this act came. If IBC was there before, things would have changed. Right? So, NCLT, can I go inside? Yes. NCLT will see the facts of the case and they will admit the application. You have played that statue game in childhood? Statue. Right? Simply have to tell statue. And then that fellow has to just stand there. There was a movie also, no? This Darna Manaya, I think. Or one more movie, where that statue thing was also a part of the story. So if you see, statue game, you would have played. So NCLT, that's the best part. When they admit the application, they will tell statue. Statue to what? All the other laws. Correct? SBI will bring a stay order. 1,600 crore, I am only not worried. Because you would have got some 2 yachts, 1, 2, 3 buildings from Vijay Mallya. So I am only not worried. No, nothing will happen. NCLT says statue. That's it. So the best part about IBC is once they admit the application, that is it. All other places, statue. That is the best part about code, codification. They said, I am the big daddy. I don't care. Can SBI come and tell, sir, this fellow only 2 lakh rupees, minus 1,800 crores. I am only not worried. NCLT says, the door is open now already. Boss, you join the queue if you want. You can't come and interfere here. Door is already open. Pilot is entering. Right? You can join the queue. The moment any person to whom the company owes 1 lakh can apply under NCLT, to NCLT under IBC. And once it is admitted, see, at the initial stage only, they'll reject it if it's not some frivolous application. Correct? But if it is really genuine, you have to prove it. You have to show all the documents. That you have to show your employment contract, everything, and you should see the bank statement, everything, they will analyze it properly. Simply, they will not admit it like that. Once admitted, you can't close it, gone. As of now, later we'll see. There are some points where you can withdraw, that later we'll see. But once you enter, that's it. Other fellows, NCLT will say, join the queue. Sir, I'm 1800 crore, I don't care, join the queue. Once they'll enter. In normal scenario, in other cases, what happens? Vijay Mallya always told, I'll pay, don't worry. Mother promise, father promise, all that. Promises he did. The thing is, he never paid. Why? Because who was in charge of the management even after the default? Vijay Mallya. Vijay Mallya, even if the company is going for winding up, who is in charge? Vijay Mallya. Here, once you enter, no? The entire list of creditors, all this, they will join the queue and they will enter here. They will go to the board of directors where Vijay Mallya is sitting here and all fellows are sitting around, all the big shots. And they say, as per in other laws, sir, please, when will you pay? When will you pay? Correct? Here, they'll just walk in and say, NCLT has already opened the door, kindly get out. Immediate suspension of board of directors. Have you ever seen this concept ever before? No. Shareholder suddenly will come. Corporate democracy. This fellow taught some four pillars and all first class. What is that? 152, 2, red with 160, then 169, 140, all that. NCLT says, I've already admitted the application. The creditors will say, shut up and sit. Suspension of shareholders' powers. It is incredible power. You can never think of it. Suspension of board, suspension of shareholders. Who will sit in the board of directors chamber? Creditors. SBI, one fellow will sit here, 1800 crores. Your PNB, all these fellows will sit around. Pilot. NCLT says, sir, allowing you only is little extra. I have allowed you, no? Sit in one corner and sit. Correct. At least in the other laws, I was not allowing you, I have allowed you. I opened the door for you. Once you come in, no, decently sit because other big shots have come. Why? Because pilot is an employee, right? He is called as an operational creditor. SBI is a financial creditor. So under IBC, operational creditor can knock on the door, door will be opened. Once you open, you enter also, no problem. But can you sit on the board? It's like a small shareholder director, can he become MD? No. Giving him director position only is a big thing. Can't be greedy. In the previous law, you have to die in the court for 20 years. Now I'm allowing you. How much? 1 lakh rupees. Earlier, I had to wait for 30, 40 lakhs not being paid. Now, 1 lakh not paid. 1 month salary not paid. Can I go to IBC? Yes. IBC is a preventive law where in the initial signs of financial distress, if anyone feels that they are not paying, rather than waiting for the next time, I can barge in. But before barging in, NCLT has to approve. Correct? Wonderful it is. And once I enter, creditors will take the possession of the board of directors and position. Possession and position, both. All that you read in 179, wiped out. IBC overrides everything. Board is supreme power, subject to IBC. Shareholders, four pillars, subject to IBC. Because they can enter the building. And once they enter, in all other cases, what used to happen? Vijay Mallya used to tell, no, I'll pay, then escape. Here, is initial signs of financial distress. Think about it, when Kingfisher was going down, not completely down, was going down, if a pilot entered, and all the creditors also came, Vijay Mallya was thrown out. And then he said, the creditors now said, please save this company. Can they manage the show, by the way? No. What will they say? Please save the company. What will they do? They will auction Kingfisher. Don't you think so? The competitors will, you know, come flying? Yes. If I say initial signs of financial distress, the competitors will come flying. That's always the case. Rather than you're completely down and out, the competitors coming and taking you over. Synergy benefit. You are already a very good name, but you are a sinking ship. What if I come and take you on? So the moment, and think about it, in the old case, Kingfisher Villa didn't get auctioned. Kingfisher logo didn't get auctioned. Now it's going down, it's not yet down. Now if I tell Kingfisher Villa you buy, Kingfisher logo 100% will buy. Some other company will come and take Kingfisher Airlines. Right? Qatar Airlines, Etihad Airlines, but that time FDI in airline industry was not allowed. Now it is to some extent. So think about all these bigger players, they know that you already have a name. Why would I change that name? Correct? That was the deal. Jet Airways, same scene with Jet Airways also. It was a wonderful aircraft. And you saw the employees, no, crying. They have worked there for 10, 15 years, crying and asking the company not to stop. Correct? So, and Jet Airways is under, it has gone through IBC. But this was the main reason why IBC came. Because they looted your and my hard-earned money. When you and I go for a loan, no loan. When they ask for a loan with a zero business plan. He played you, best part. He took money from you only. How? Banks. He invested in those seats, etc. Fine. Then he came to you and said, I'm going to give you luxury. For that, who had to pay for tickets? We only. And then he said, free chocolate, free, what do you say? It was actually a scam. It was nothing but a scam. And when everyone came and told, when will you pay salary? He said, I'll pay tomorrow, day after tomorrow. Then he ran away. Today, sitting in London, he has the audacity to say, I did not default on the loans. Kingfisher did it. Solomon versus Solomon, CPT. He actually told that. He didn't say Solomon versus Solomon. He said that for that he should. No. For that, obviously his lawyers would have said, he actually told this dialogue. You can check on YouTube. I was searching for that video. Didn't find. I saw an interview. He said, I have not defaulted on any loans. It is Kingfisher. Kingfisher is a separate legal entity. I have not done it. But when you wanted a loan, you begged. And when you cheated the employees, you begged. So that is and this is just the tip of the iceberg. Now I am seeing the other scam, 90,000 crore. This fellow is one kid. 7,000 crore, that's all. 90,000, ILFS, 90,000 crore it is, scam. This is 7,000. But this was just the tip of the iceberg. And for that, we needed a robust system. Under this robust system, a pilot can go knock on saying that 1 lakh they have not paid, sir. I think the company is going down. Please accept. So before anything can happen, NCLT will see the merits of the case and allow. Then all the creditors will come in and they'll throw the management out and ask the shareholders to shut their mouths and sit. And then until now, the best part was what? Statue. Other cases will take on how long? 20 years, 30 years. This is a wonderful law, believe it or not. 180 days. That's it. You need to resolve in 180 days. We'll explain everything, just the basic structure. 180 days you need to resolve. And that statute period is 180 days. Correct? So in a writing you can't say the NCLT will put statute. What should you write? Correct? Obviously you can't write like that. There's a term, legal term for that is called moratorium. BCom it'll happen, not in CA. Correct? Moratorium. So the moment NCLT says accepted, that's it, statue. That statue is called moratorium. Moratorium freezes all other cases, just like that. Everything just, gets frozen. I understand the concept, guys. Once you understand concept, everything is chiller. You need to understand the history. Not blindly reading what does section say. What is a preamble? No point. So once you understand the logic, that's it. Life settled. That is how you should always study. So moratorium, that's it. Moratorium, that 180 days, nothing. 180 days I can't do. Okay, fine. One extra time, one time extension of up to 90 days. Just one time. I can't say give me in two installments of 45 days. No. Just one time extension of up to 90. Which means in 180 plus 90, 270 days I have to shut shop and close the deal. What do you mean by close the deal? In 270 days, the creditor should find a what? Buyer. How will they find the buyer? They will auction the company. Correct? They will ask for people to come and, you know, bid. The person who is coming and asking, I mean, who is saying that I am interested in you, that is called expression of interest. EOI, EOI. From various sources, expression of interest will come. Each person who is giving EOI should give something called as a resolution plan. Resolution plan. This board of directors are gone. Who is sitting there? Creditors. One fancy name should we should give. COC. Committee of Creditors. Fancy name. Correct? COC. Committee of Creditors should now analyze each and every RP. RP means resolution plan. What is resolution plan? How will I resolve the show? First, when I open it, it should say, how much money are you going to give me? I am the creditor. This company owes me 7,000 crore. You decently pay me. You do whatever the hell you want. Take over the company. Or is the plan saying that I'll pay you 4,500 crore now, for the remaining portion come become the shareholder? Possible. Let us try restructuring the loan. I'll pay you in these many installments. Possible. So the new company that is coming in not only should repay the loan but also should take over and should give the plan of what the future will be, because shareholders are there now still. Wonderful. So in the initial signs of financial distress itself, the companies will lap it up. Will lap it up. That's how it happens everywhere. So that's how it really happens at all places. So whether you, I mean, that's how in all the places it happens. Correct? Not just big, big companies. Even smaller business, they'll come and just take over. The what happened with L&T? They wanted to buy out which one? Mindtree. That was a hostile takeover. So when they see an opportunity, it doesn't mean that the company is going down. When they see an opportunity, they want to buy out. So here also same thing. When the initial sense of finance, I always had my eyes on Kingfisher. Can't I buy it? Yes. So that's what the other people will come. That's called resolution plan. They will decide on the resolution plan and choose the best resolution plan. Resolution plan should involve payment of all the creditors, including the pilot. Pilot is sitting in the corner. Pilot also has to be paid. He had the guts to knock on the door. He was given entry. Correct? And then what happened? They said, okay, I will look after you also. I'll look after you also. Both. Resolution plan. Why the hell should I study all this? That question you need to ask. The thing is, will pilot go knock on the door? No, he will hire a person. He is called as a IRP, Insolvency Resolution Professional. Dangerous if you write Insolvent Resolution Professional. Correct? Yes. That is the scene now. Articles, Insolvent Professionals. Once we clear, Insolvency Professionals. So, Insolvency Resolution Professional. He will knock on the door. Pilot will not know anything. Will creditors join? No. The insolvency, each creditor, SBI will appoint one IRP. All banks will appoint IRPs. IRPs will knock. IRPs will enter. IRPs will sit on the table. Managing the show. IRPs will analyze each and every resolution plan. And IRP will finally give it to NCLT. NCLT will either accept the plan or reject the plan. If they accept, well and good. New companies will come, take over, pay off everyone. Everyone will be happy. If they reject the plan, then liquidation. Now do you know why liquidation was removed under Companies Act? Because liquidation is now under IBC. Liquidation is no longer there in Companies Act. What liquidation is there? Winding up, compulsory winding up by NCLT. That is a different thing. This is what? Voluntary winding up. voluntary winding up is completely under IBC. That's why if you see all those cases were repealed, all those sections, right? Because it's no longer there. So it's absurd for them to give questions in winding up, but they still give. ICAI still gives questions on winding up. One question here and there, it will come. Got it? So liquidation is other process where now nobody wants to buy and no resolution plan was worth it, close it down. But before that, there is a hope that in the initial signs of financial distress, I'll give my damn company to somebody else. That is, some hope is there. Now the best part is, who are these IRPs? Chartered accountants. That is the reason why we have to study. Who are these IRPs? Chartered accountants, company secretaries, lawyers, professionals. Will you become a CA and directly walk in? No, you have to write one more exam. You have to write the exam. The IRP exam you have to write. Insolvency, if you want to become an insolvency professional, you have to write the exam. Correct? Your first is limited insolvency exam is there. One more is normal insolvency exam. That is there. Correct? So all these exams we need to write. Who will write this? CA, CS. If you become a... Now can you write? You guys, can you write now? No. And the chapters are similar to company law subject. With an addition of here and there, it's an MCQ based thing. 60% is the pass mark. And the best part about IB, this thing is, once you walk in, you will be like a management. You will run the show. When the COC is formed, what is the first decision that the COC should take? Yeah, from all that group is there, no? One leader they have to appoint. All IRPs will be sitting, one leader they have to appoint. And before that, all, till that point, they formed the COC, no, actually. They formed the COC. They have to be paid. First order of business is they have to be paid. Then they'll appoint a leader. Leader will take it forward. Then once leader takes it forward, when the new RP comes, that is your resolution plan comes, what is the first thing that is there? Pay my fees. I am doing the entire thing, pay my fees. Let's say it goes for liquidation. Once the first asset is sold, the first rupee should go to whom? Liquidator. Who is the liquidator? You only. So it's a very, very, very lucrative business. Many lawyers, almost 40-50% lawyers have quit their practice and now they are insolvency professionals, including chartered accountants as well. Very, very lucrative. There is money in closing down companies and there's also money in reviving the companies. That's why Modi said that you are the doctor, like a doctor looking after the financial health of the company. You need to look after the financial health. You can kill it or you can revive. You can do euthanasia and kill it or you can revive it. And that's what you're trying to do. You're trying to revive the companies. How will you revive that? Think about it, guys. All a group of CA, company secretary, all sitting together, COC, they're representing each of these clients, which means not that you need to knock the door. Pilot also will appoint one fellow. They will knock the door. That's not that, just that. Every creditor will appoint one guy. So who are the two people who can knock? Financial creditor also can knock and operational creditor also can knock. Can Vijay Mallya only open the door? Please come, I'm dying. Can you do it? Yes. Third person is called corporate debtor. That's the wonderful thing in IBC. If you cannot do it, put the white flag and allow them to come. Do not fight it. So three people can apply for IBC. First, financial creditor. Second, operational creditor. Third one, corporate debtor itself. You only open the door. Correct? Which authority will I go? NCLT. And it is so wonderful now that all these data will be stored in a database. And Vijay Mallya, when he took loan, for what he took loan, everything will be stored in a database now. And that database will be maintained by the maintenance company only should have 5,000 crore net worth, 500 crore net worth. The company which maintains the database. Big, big companies maintain that. They are service providers. So next time, first is initial signs of distress. Next time if Vijay Mallya goes and tells, I want a loan, They'll allot a number for that. They'll tell, it's like an Aadhaar card, give me your number, that corporate number. Once you click on that number, you will get the full history, geography of that particular person and that company. When they took a loan, what loan they took, how much, what is the rescheduling, when did they pay, everything. They are creating a mammoth database to ensure that next time crony capitalism will not work. So this is called IU. It is IO seen only for the businessman. IU is what? Information utility. This is one more concept. Information utility. Large, you know, data banks. So today, first one part is initial signs of financial distress. Other part is what? Now Kingfisher wants to again beg for a loan. People are ready to give, throw money, tell him I'll give you one more house. People will, who are the persons approving? Bank means what? Manager only, no? AGM, DGM, that fellow, throw some 2-3 houses, that's it, you'll get it. Now nothing doing. Before this, you have to click in that in the database. IU will generate that report, see that report, only give. Which means at the beginning only I'm cutting it down. I will not give you money. What you will do, whatever you do not deserve that money. Correct? That is one part of it. So that this is a wonderful legislation where I'm trying to reduce the NPA by not giving to people who don't deserve it. Second, rather than waiting for you to die and then go through some 1,000 laws, I'm giving you a chance where 1 lakh if you don't pay, the initial signs of financial distress, open up your company so that other liquid companies can come and take over. And if nothing works out, liquidation. But at the initial signs of financial distress, the people who will manage the entire show from beginning till the end would be your resolution professionals. When you enter, it's called an interim resolution professional. And once you, of the group of IRPs, you will appoint one guy, that is called as an RP. RP is two RP. One is resolution plan, one is resolution professional. That's the thing. Now, one more thing I'm going to ask you. Your friends, you would not have paid your friends money, no? Now, you'll go for breakfast when I give. You'll be waiting for breakfast, I know. I'll give you some time, 1 second. So, when you go out, you'll say, today I didn't get wallet money, you only pay. Your friend pays. Your friend has been paying since a long time. He has his app also, Splitwise. In Splitwise app, his share is, his contribution or rather his, whatever he owes you is zero. And you have to pay some like 1,700 rupees or something. So he'll tell, boss, pay this, no, what is this? 1,700 and again you're asking. Correct? So the thing is, fine, no problem. Now in this full josh after today, both of you are sitting here, tomorrow you have not paid. Some 1,500 or whatever, you have not paid. Tomorrow you get a notice under IBC. You have not paid this amount. If you don't pay, you will be declared insolvent. You will tell for declaring insolvent, what? I'll declare myself. For a person is already insolvent, nothing to declare. Anyway, that's beside the point. Tell me, can you do that for individuals also? Or is it only for companies? Can you open up this insolvency proceeding for individual, like your friend? What do you think? Yes or no? Yes. Answer is yes. What is the amount? 1,000 rupees. So friends, beware. Today only settle it. Correct? 1,000 rupees, I am not kidding. 1,000 bucks. They have amended all the old laws. This is the old law, all that. What are the old laws quickly? Companies Act, subject to CLB. It was CLB before, subject to IBC. Anyway, Companies Act repealed, leave it. SICA amended, subject to IBC. RDBFI amended, subject to IBC. SURFACE, subject to IBC. Everywhere they have written it subject to IBC. So once IBC came, there was an amendment in all the laws. Earlier, there was DRT, Debt Recovery Tribunal, which was looking after the insolvency of the companies also under RDBFI and all those things. Now what they are saying, for individuals, what about partnership firms? For individuals and partnership firms, it will all be looked after by DRT. For companies, it will be looked after by NCLT. That is the scene. So, if you see this entire thing, you will understand this structure. Page number 1.2. Page number 1.2. Just like ICAI regulates CA Institute, who will regulate securities market? SEBI. Who regulates banks? RBI. Who regulates insurance companies? IRDA. Just like that, who regulates the insolvency process? IBBI. Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. And I have my adjudicating authority under this entire scheme of things. In that, I have three things under IBBI: Insolvency Professional Agency, IPA, Insolvency Professionals, that is Chartered Accountant and all, and Information Utility, IU. Insolvency Professional Agency is what? CA Institute, CS Institute, CMA Institute. What are they? As usual, examination conducting bodies. So, after CA, you want to write this exam, you still have to go and die in Vasant Nagar. Correct? Exam will be conducted there. Correct? All application form, etc. available at Vasant Nagar office. But this time when you enter, that lady who is sitting there who never smiles at you, will smile because you are a CA. Correct? She will only smile once you become a CA. You remember that lady once you enter, that left hand. She never smiles. Now she is smiling. Yeah, maybe after I keep telling about her in every class, somebody would have gone and told. That's the thing. So, that lady never smiles. It happened with, she never smiles. So rude she is. But when you become a CA, she will show her full 30, 40 teeth. 36 plus GST. She has 40. Right? So, she shows. Become a CA. I was going for a talk there. All everywhere my name was there. That when you enter, I will welcome. As if, you know, they will welcome me. But anyway, it's there. But there, then that lady stood up and I was shocked. I said, madam, it will snow in today. She didn't understand the joke. Correct? Anyway. So, Insolvency Professional Agency. So, ICSI, IPA. Those people only are the president of ICAI, president of India, all those things. Anyway. Yeah, no problem. But I tell it in every class, maybe somebody would have told. That's why she's smiling now. Yes. So, these three agencies are the examination bodies, right? Then, IP, Insolvency Professional. That is you all, you guys only. Then, Information Utility. Adjudicating authority would be what? As I told you, for corporates, LLP and personal guarantees related to corporate debtors. Is this there in your thing? It's there, okay. Some changes here and there are there. NCLT. Who is the appellate authority? NCLAT. And who is the next authority? Supreme Court. High Court is not there. NCLT, NCLAT, and directly have to go to Supreme Court. On the other hand, for individuals and partnerships, DRT, Debt Recovery Tribunal, DRAT, Debt Recovery Appellate Tribunal, and Supreme Court. This is the full scene. For corporates, LLP, and personal guarantee, NCLT, NCLAT, Supreme Court. For individuals and partnership firm, DRT, Debt Recovery Tribunal, Debt Recovery Appellate Tribunal, and Supreme Court. And the sense that we have this entire scene, insolvency, bankruptcy, winding up, liquidation, dissolution. What's the difference between insolvency and bankruptcy? We have answered the first question, difference between Act and Code. Second question, insolvency, bankruptcy difference. Sorry? But general meaning difference? Insolvency is a condition where our assets are, obviously our liabilities are far in excess of the assets. It is a condition. But when it goes to court, the technical name given is called bankruptcy proceedings. General meaning I am giving. Insolvency is a feeling, articleship. Insolvency, that's a feeling, it's an emotion. Whereas the actual process when I apply to a court, that is called bankruptcy proceedings. However, under this act, insolvency relates to corporates. Insolvency is the term related to the process given for corporates. And bankruptcy is for non-corporates. As she said, one is for individuals and partnership firms. That is why it is called insolvency and bankruptcy code. Insolvency is for companies, bankruptcy is for individuals and partnership firms. Bankruptcy proceedings are not yet notified. So you can still can't sue your friend. You can take today from your friend again. Correct? 1,000 rupees, that's it. What we have for our exam is insolvency, this proceeding. This entire thing, no, 180 plus 90 days. So what happened? Just the gist pilot came, then NCLT opened up the entire thing. Then he said statue, 180 plus 90. At the end of statue, all other fellows came and all that. Then either they accept or reject. If they reject, the only possible thing is liquidation. This is your entire application. How will you apply? Who will apply and all that? This entire process is called CIRP, Corporate Insolvency Resolution Process. Corporate Insolvency Resolution Process. And then finally, liquidation. Once the company goes for liquidation, I will sell all the assets at fair market value and distribute them in something called as the waterfall mechanism. You would have done in BCom liquidation of an under Companies Act, correct? You would have taken all that outsiders, workmen's dues, all that one step after the step you would have taken. That is liquidation under which act? Companies Act. But this is liquidation, distribution of assets are done in the waterfall mechanism. I had just guessed that this question will come. It came for 8 marks, 2 attempts before. They gave you an entire list, correct? So in the Q&A book, I have given that, the entire list they had given. And they had asked you 8 marks or 6 to 8 marks. You know, what is the waterfall mechanism? So easy it is. You just had to remember the waterfall mechanism. So for our exam, what will come? The entire process of application, the entire process of CIRP, and the entire process of liquidation. Around 60 sections will be applicable for our exam. Other things and all here and there, okay, but these 60 are the main things. Institute doesn't know what to give. So what do they give? Decided case laws here and there, important ones here and there. And they didn't know what to do. So they had released a FAQ to the CAs, frequently asked questions. Then they started frequently asking the same in CA exams. Correct? So in my notes, as I told you, I have already given you the entire structure and all that. And rather than you going and buying that, I have reproduced the same. That is the FAQs given by ICI with the necessary modifications I have given. Stick to that notes more than enough. My chart and notes more than enough to clear. And of course the Q&A. You have to solve the Q&A. I have given in depth in IBC. I have taken your previous year's question papers, your RTPs and your, what is that called? Mock exams, ICI mock exams, everything. Stick to this and you can pocket 8 to 10 marks, whatever it is. Unless they give some random question, which I have never asked. But mostly around this only they will ask. So one part of the notes is my normal entire structure. Chart book is the best to just revise the entire process. And of course that FAQ you can just go through. Correct? If you see the material, FAQ you can go through. So here if you see around, so this is a question by the way. Now May 19, page number 1.47, May 19, they asked this question. Anyway, so this is all the stuff. All these are things, previous year's question, miscellaneous and all that. There have been couple of important changes that have come. If you see page number 1.52, there have been two amendments. One is the First Amendment Act, and now Amendment Act that came on 16th August 2019, which I have collated in 1.52. Page number 1.52. Do you have the same number? 1.52. This is the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Amendment Act 16th August 2019. For the first time ever, it will come in where? May 2020. Correct? Now you will write VVVVVIMP. Star, star, star. All that. Yes. So, May 20 onwards. May 20 onwards, it will come. So, that's the thing. These are all important changes. Again, for each of this, I will give you the history, why it changed and all. And before that, we had the IBC Amendment Ordinance in 2018. What is the difference in Ordinance and Act? Ordinance is passed by Parliament. Ordinance is passed by whom?
President.
Ordinance is passed by the President when the houses are not functioning. Otherwise also houses don't function, but anyway, when they really are not functioning, then the, they'll pass an ordinance. And then it should be approved after, 5 to 6 weeks from the day Parliament comes into session. That's the thing. So that Ordinance plus Act, both will be there. Ordinance ka logic I've given here. After that, these are all general reading. But this page number 1.59, important FAQs issued by ICI. This is like the revision of the entire chapter anyway. So basically you have 59 pages, that's it. 58 pages. Next 40 pages, 30 pages, just revision. So this you can just quickly go through. Institute initially copy pasted from this only and gave. FAQs issued to whom? CS. It's like a revision, honestly. There is like a revision. Aramsha, when you want to revise, you can go through all these questions. Everything is there in this. So, my notes and this charts here, obviously, and the Q&A book would be more than sufficient to crack this thing, 8 to 10 marks. And the same will eventually continue for economic law elective as well. For electives, they will give you more case laws. Whatever decided case laws are there, they'll convert to a case study. They'll change the names. That's it. So that's how they do it. So once this structure is there, there one chapter is sorted for you. That is if you like the laws. If you don't like law, if you think that, okay, this is like not my cup of tea, don't take it. I keep on repeating. Yesterday also some students are asking me what to do. Should I take this or that? I said, boss, you see what you want to take. Correct? So, if these things really you like doing it or maybe, and questions are not going to be easy. I am not going to tell, it's very easy, come. No, it's not going to be easy. November 19 was a tricky paper. Correct? It's not going to be easy. But the thing is, if you have a flair for it, I like analyzing, and it's not, evaluation is not going to be tough. Because the questions itself are, you know, quite tricky. So, in each law, you have some 6-7 laws, in each law they will give you one case study. And if you are ustad in all subjects, then that multidisciplinary case study you can take. That if you want. And that's why only 10 people only take that. 10 people, 20 people, out of so many people, only 10 people take that. That is all subjects. Anyway. So, one last part and then we'll take a break. Last part. Page number 1.3. Yes. First, what should happen? There should be an occurrence of default. Last part. Occurrence of default. What do you mean by occurrence of default? There is one star point here. I am reading page number 1.3 in the chart book. Occurrence of default. And occurrence of default means what? Minimum amount of default must be how much? 1 lakh. Minimum amount of default must be 1 lakh. CG may provide for a higher minimum amount, not beyond 1 crore. This is not now, later. 20 years later, 1 lakh will be some peanut amount. Even now it is. If you give 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs and all, now they are rejecting outright. Correct? Because they are now looking at higher value amounts. CG may provide for higher minimum amount, not beyond 1 crore. Tomorrow they can say minimum application amount should be 20 lakhs. Can CG prescribe? Yes. Can CG prescribe minimum application amount should be 1.5 crores? Default? No. Default is non-payment of debt or wholly or partly. That's it. Now, occurrence of default. The creditors or shareholders can make an application to whom? This fellow. Who's this fellow? NCLT. And NCLT will appoint you guys. See, Ustad in all subjects. Right? Lady is not there. Only man he has put. Feminism alert. No. Actually, of the two, this was slightly better. Again, because of the pixelation and all the one we created, that's the only reason, nothing else. So, interim, resolution, professional. Interim, resolution, professional. It has to come on print, low pixelation, etc. Other issues are technical issues, nothing else. So, if you see, Creta, shareholders, and NCLT, and then interim, resolution, professionals. Correct? And you can make them a lady also if you want. That's it. That's the thing. So, whatever you want. So, interim resolution, professional. That's the entire thing. So, once you come inside as an interim, so they will appoint. So, as I told you, this can be a pilot, by the way. Operational creator. He will go to NCLT. With his friend, he'll go. This fellow only is a friend. So, NCLT will see whether this friend even has cleared the exam. That also you have to see, no? NCLT will do that basic check. Whether he has cleared the exam. He just cleared yesterday. Yesterday, he got results. Can he become Kingfisher IRP? No. So they say, what is your experience, see all that, and then they will only appoint that guy or they'll appoint somebody else. Correct? They will see the experience because lot of frivolous applications and random fellows are becoming IRP. Now they have one screening mechanism also. NCLT will talk to IBBI. In consultation with the regulator IBBI, there's a database of experience now actually. When did you pass? What is your experience? How many have you done? All these things you need to see. Blindly, you can't give it to whoever you want, right? So, after that, the IRP will be appointed. Once IRP will be appointed, what will happen? You know, other things will happen. And who are the three people? Only the people will not see the definition, nothing. Three people. Financial creator, SBI. Operational creator, pilot. Corporate debtor itself, Kingfisher Airlines. That's it. And the entire process is called CIRP, Corporate Insolvency Resolution Process. So, what is it all about, what it is, how to do and all, we will see after the break.